Hello friends, welcome to another video. Today's video, we are going to explore some Power Query functions and see how powerful these functions are to achieve our data transformation and preparation needs. Let's look at our data in Power Query and look at the problem, what we're trying to solve, and the final solution. What I have here is a data for two or three columns here, two columns, amount and amount one and is zero. So ask here is this question. This was actually posted on Power BI community forum. The ask here was look into all the number columns. In this case, amount and amount one is a number column, and check if the value in these columns, all of these columns, is equal to zero. Then add another column called is zero with the true or false. For example, in row number 7, amount is 430, amount 1 is 0, and this is false. When the amount in both the columns, when the value in both the columns, amount and amount 1 is 0, then it is true. So basically, look into all the number fields or columns. Now, the one way to do this is, as the way I did it here is I added a custom column. I called it if amount, not if amount is equal to zero and amount one is equal to zero, and that it gave us true or false, and that's what is working. So this is perfectly fine solution, nothing wrong with it. But there are a couple of challenges with this. One of the challenges, let's say if I rename the amount one to something else prior to adding this is zero column, then there will be an error in this particular column, right? This conditional column we added. Or for example, another thing is, if there is another column, let's say amount two, and that get added, and now we also want to check that amount two column value is equal to zero, it means we have to come back to this our conditional column is zero, and then add another condition, amount is equal to zero, amount one is equal to zero, and amount two is equal to zero. So basically, if any column get added, and for example, which is a number column, or if a column get renamed, we have to come back to our this conditional column we added and make the changes to that. This is what brings up to these Power Query functions, which I want to showcase in this video, how we can make it in a way that if any column get renamed, this conditional column still works. Plus, if any new column get added, which is of a type number, and still this functionality works. So let's take a look at that, how we can achieve it. I'm gonna delete this added is zero column for now. So the first ask is, if we look into the problem, the first ask is to find out what columns are the number columns in our data. We can easily achieve this by using columns of type function available in Power Query to get the type, only the columns with the number field. So let me add a column here and showcase. So it's going to call custom column. Again, I'm going to make this step by step, and then eventually we're going to wrap this into one single conditional column. So let's call it number columns. That's the new column we are adding. So there is a function called table dot columns of type. And then you have to give a table, the first parameter. So that will be our previous step. In this case, is the change type step. So I'm gonna, okay, in my change type, that's my table. And then there is a list of types. What kind of list type we want to check? So we're gonna say type nullable number. So what I expect this to give us a list of the number columns. So basically, if we look at this, as you can see, this added a list. So what we have is we have amount and amount one. So we got two columns only. Even we have a date column. If we had another column, for example, any text column, customer name, that would not have part of this list. If there was another column get added prior to this, let's say amount 2 or amount 3, we will still, those columns will automatically get added into this list. So first part is solved, that we able to identify what are the columns of type number. So that's the first thing. Now, the second part of this is we have to check the value of all these two columns right now, amount and amount 1 is equal to 0. Now, before we do that, I'm going to add another column here just to showcase again. The first thing what we need is we need to find a record, all the values in our row. So what we can do is there is a function record to list. So basically what does that means is the current row we are at, give this the values as in a list. And if you put the underscore, it means that particular record, the row, and then we go okay. So now what we expect to see here is actually, let's change it to column name to record as list. So we know what we're talking about, record as list. That's the name of the column. So in this case, what we expect to see, if we go click in here, what we're seeing is, we are seeing the date, we are seeing value of amount one, amount and amount one, and of course the number column. So that's what we are getting. So now we have found there's a function we used, record to list, to convert our record or our row into a list. And why we are doing it in the list, converting the list, I will show you guys why we need this as in a list. Now, one thing we have here is we are not interested in any of the column except amount and amount one, because our ask is to look at the values in the number fields. So how we can achieve that? What we're going to do is we're going to take advantage of a function called record.selectFields. So before we do that, let me add another custom column here. I'm gonna show you guys here. So let's call it record as field. And so what I'm gonna do is record.selectFields. So what I want is, I want to select the fields, right? So if I go underscore, it means this current row as in a record, and then field as many. So that means whatever the fields we want. So now in this particular case, we are only interested in those number field. So what we can use is we already have a column called number columns, which is giving us the list of amount and amount one. We can use that, or we can directly type that command here as well. But let's use that column. So that is called number columns. And just to clarify, the number columns here is, we already did that. It's giving us only two columns, which are of type number, because that's what we wanted in this one. So record as a field, when we went added this, so what we're getting is now we're getting only two columns, amount and amount one, because what we said is from this record, I want only those fields which are part of the number columns list, right? So that's what it is. And now what we can do is, because we are not interested in the record, we want to convert this into list. And what we can do is we can wrap this into record to list. So that means we will not get all the value of all the columns, but only we will get for amount and amount one. So what we're going to do is, so first we're going to come back here, and record to list. So now we see this as in a list, and we get only two values, 181, 181, because that's what it is. If we come to this particular row and we get 00, so that's working. And if you look at the previous column we added, record as list, we had the value of all the columns, which we are not interested in. We are only interested in the value of two columns, which is amount and amount one. And why we're interested in that? Because we only want to check the number fields, and we know what the number fields are, which we created in our column we added called number columns, and that's what we already know those are. So now we got the list of the values what we are interested in. So the final step, what we want to do here is check the value for each list item. And if it is zero, it means all the number columns contain the value zero. If any one of that is not zero, it means the one of the column, we are not interested which column, but one of the column does not has the value zero. So how we do that? Let me show you another function here called list.matchesAll. And that function, you can read the official documentation on Power BI Microsoft website. But what does that means is we're gonna match the value zero in each of the line item in the list. And what we're gonna do is let's add another column here, and we're gonna call it is zero now. And what that function is, and that's one of the reason was why we wanted to convert our record to the list, because we have a functionality or a function available, which is list.matchesAll. And the first argument is list, and then we have the record as field, comma, then each list item we want to compare against zero. So each, that's the second part of this, what we comparison is underscore, it will give us the value of the each list item is equal to zero. That's what we want to compare. So now if we go, okay, so we will see true or false. So here you go. This one is true. The reason behind that is amount and amount one is true in this particular, both contains a value zero. Now, how this is powerful, and let me go back to the source. I manually enter the data here, and if we come back here and update the data or add another column and change it to amount two. So we have, this is amount two. We just copy the data. And now if we go okay here, and in this particular, in next step, what we have is a change type step. Our amount two is still a text column. And just to make sure, if we go to edit custom one and number of columns is still showing amount and amount one because amount two is text column. If I come back to my change type step and change it to, let's say, whole number, go to edit custom. And if we look at what we have is now we have three columns, it means, and even if we rename the columns, does not matter. Let's say amount one is, if we go back change type, and let's say for whatever reason, we change amount one to amount X, right? It does not matter. What would happen is the list, which was a list of fields, will still give us those three columns with now new name, amount, amount X, and amount two. So everything is working fine. And if we come back to edit custom two, what we will see is record as a field will only give us values, those three columns, which is 181, 181. Previously, we were seeing two rows here, two list items. Now we're seeing three because we have three amount columns in this particular case. Again, name of the column in this does not matter in this because we already know what the type number fields are. And now the last step is again match all, and then everything should work, no error. The rename of the columns happened, new column get added, we still get the true for this. Now what it is doing is it is checking the value of zero in all these three columns, which is amount, amount X, and amount two, and giving us true and false. Now I added all these columns together. Well, we don't need to do that. We can add another custom column, one single custom column, and then achieve this. Let me actually show you that. And then I'm gonna delete all the steps and just add one custom column by putting all this thing together. Okay, so we have a custom column, and then I have already copied from a notepad. So basically what we have is, first we have a list of all the number columns, and then we wrapped this into record.select field, so we only get the fields we are interested in, and then we converted that values into the list. And once we have the list, then we are using list match all and comparing each list item is equal to zero or not, and then okay, everything is working. As you can see, it's giving us one single custom column we added, and with all the functions together, and we got the result what we are looking for. As with this solution, you saw, even if we add new columns of type number or we rename the column, our is0 function will still work. It will not break. The reason behind that is because we're using all those different functions to get the data. We are not hard coding any value if amount is equal to 0 or amount 1 is equal to 0. We are getting the list of columns which are of type number, and then we get converting those into a list, and then we are using the list matches all to find out if all contains the value 0. Let me know what you guys think about this video. I know these Power Query functions are not commonly used, but they are very, very powerful. You just have to think a little bit, break it down step by step, and then put everything together. I hope you learned some of the functionality from this video and able to use it in your solutions as well. Please do subscribe my channel. There's more videos I'm working on and some interesting videos. Until next video, have a great day. Thanks for watching. Thanks for supporting. And make sure share with your network and do subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified when the new video comes out. Thank you very much. Bye for now. Thanks a lot.